The eight Gamera films released between 1965 and 1980 were never anything more than cheap, silly monster movies aimed at kids. This didn't spare the franchise from ridicule. In the late 1980s, the comedy TV show Mystery Science Theater 3000 introduced a new generation to the giant turtle Gamera when they ruthlessly mocked several of his films. In 1995, Daiei Studios released Gamera, Guardian of the Universe, the first Gamera movie in 15 years. Unlike the campy originals, Guardian of the Universe wanted to be taken seriously, with a darker tone and much less emphasis on the goofiness and bratty children that defined the earlier films. As a more mature giant monster film, Gamera, Guardian of the Universe, is a success. The story and characters are interesting, and the creature action is solid and enhanced by very good special effects. Guardian of the Universe does get a bit outlandish at times. It is a giant monster movie after all. But it keeps these moments to a minimum. Guardian of the Universe does the unthinkable. It makes Gamera respectable. Kita. While sailing near the Philippine Islands, a ship runs aground on a rocky atoll that wasn't supposed to be there. Not only that, but the atoll is drifting. Meanwhile, an ornithologist travels to a remote island to look for a professor who went missing while investigating a previously undiscovered species of large bird. Something has attacked and eaten the inhabitants of the island. To be precise, three very large birds that resemble pterodactyls have attacked and consumed everyone. Fearing that the creatures might attack people on the Japanese mainland, the government wants the birds to be captured so they can be studied further. This will end well. While the birds are being led towards a domed baseball stadium with a retractable roof, the atoll rumbles to life and heads towards Japan. It seems like the plan to catch the birds has worked. One of the creatures realizes it's a trap and escapes before the stadium's roof can be closed. Before the bird can get too far, an enormous turtle rises from the sea and kills it. The turtle, Gamera, comes ashore and makes a beeline towards the baseball stadium, crushing everything in its path. This is the first major special effects sequence in Guardian of the Universe, and it looks good, with lots of explosions and buildings toppling over as Gamera stomps around. The action is old-fashioned. Actor in a monster suit knocks over model building stuff that has been done for years, but it's high quality, a far cry from the bargain basement monster scenes from the old Gamera films. Gamera himself looks different, but still recognizable. His head is more angular. His eyes are differently shaped and more expressive, and his tusks and spines are sharper and more pronounced, giving him a meaner appearance. Gamera's roar is the same one from the original movies, but this isn't the same turtle. Guardian of the Universe is a reboot that mostly ignores the older films. Despite his best efforts, Gamera can't keep the other two birds from escaping the baseball stadium, and he flies off. With some downtime until the next monster scene, researchers decipher Gamera's backstory. He's made by the people of the lost continent of Atlantis to defend them against attacks from the giant birds, which are called Gauss. Gamera was created too late to save Atlantis, but if the Gauss appeared again, he would be ready. Gamera. Scenes like these in other monster movies can become tedious, but they're interesting in Guardian of the Universe, informative but not overly talky and dull. The characters are interesting and likable, a welcome change from the old Gamera movies that put annoying kids front and center. The youngest character in Guardian of the Universe is a girl named Asagi, who is at least high school age. Thanks to a bead found on the atoll, Asagi has a psychic link to Gamera. If you're into trivia, Asagi is played by Yako Fujitani, the daughter of action movie star Steven Seagal. The Japanese government doesn't know what to make of Gamera, but when he saves some people from a Gauss attack, it becomes obvious that he's on the side of humanity. This doesn't stop the military from attacking them, though. Gamera retreats into the ocean, but he'll be needed soon, as the one remaining Gauss has grown to enormous size and made a nest in downtown Tokyo. This sets the stage for the final showdown. Gamera and the Super Gauss do battle, crushing much of the city as they wrestle and throw each other around. At one point, the combat is even taken into outer space. It's a fun battle filled with explosions and property damage. Some of the visuals of the creatures flying are kind of iffy, though, and detract from the overall quality of the special effects a little bit. The climactic moments in Guardian of the Universe are satisfying and leave the door open for a sequel, which would be released in 1996. Gamera was always viewed as inferior to Godzilla, but Guardian of the Universe showed that he could not only legitimately compete with the King of the Monsters, but beat him at his own game too.